Now, this other ticketing software is called UVsoft, I think? Oh, no, UVdesk. And a massive shout out to Marius Hosting for offering a pretty good guide on setting it up with Docker Compose, which makes things so much easier. Now, he's talking about a Synology NAS. If you want to do that, follow along right here. I'll link below. But all we care about is grabbing this file right here, a Docker Compose file. Now, I've got my own little version right here that I copied from him. And here in my terminal, I'm going to do two things. First, I'll make a new directory, call this UVdesk. I'll cd into that, and then I'll create a new file, nano docker-compose.yml. I will paste all that config, control X, Y, enter to save, and with one command, docker-compose up-d, it'll come up. And if you're like, hey, what is Docker Compose? What is this magic happening on the screen? I've got a video somewhere right here where we geek out about Docker Compose. It's so cool. Anyways, it's almost done. Quick coffee break. Well, it is done. If we do a docker ps, I can see my two new Docker containers running, and it looks like port 80. Let's try it out. I'll minimize my terminal, get back to Linode, grab my reverse DNS URL here, and just go out to the port 80. It should work, I think, right? Let's specify 80 at the end, just to be safe. Oh no, not 5001. Calm down. Oh no, maybe it's 6744. I got it backwards. There we go. Now just a few things we have to do to get this set up. Let's begin. Cool, everything's good. Proceed. This is kind of annoying, but Mario makes it easy for us. Thank you, Mario. Server will be UVdesk underscore DB underscore one. Port works out, that's good. Username is UVdesk. Password is NetworkChuck, if you copied mine. Database is UVdesk. This should work, let's proceed. Good to go. It was just making sure it had a good connection to the database because we're running MySQL. And then we'll create a super admin account. And proceed. Proceed once more and install now. All right, I think that's it. Now, like I said, this one has a bit more features, like a knowledge base. And that's one cool thing about a ticketing software that's worth its salt. As you solve tickets for your company, there might be a certain ticket you solved that needs to go into the knowledge base because you might see that issue over and over and over. So new people that come in, junior admins, or even other people in your team can be like, oh, I'll just search the knowledge base and I can solve that problem. So create your own little knowledge base. So looking at the admin here, I haven't played with this too much, but I know it's pretty cool. Let's get logged in. This thing is feature filled. You can do a lot. So this is for all you nerds who really want to geek out, which is probably a lot of you. But again, I'm not going to cover everything here. You can play with this and figure it out. That's part of being in IT. I was just showing you how to get there. So that's the video. Two ticketing softwares you can set up yourself, self-host, and I'm actually running both of these ticketing softwares on Linode, which is pretty stinking cool.